small and medium sized hospitals. As a result of this, many medical professionals, healthcare professionals, which includes doctors, nurses, ward boys, have been laid off. They've been asked to go on leave, indefinite leave, and their pay is not protected. They don't know whether they'll come back to work. At this time of crisis, we need every medical professional to be on our side, and it is important that their pay, their leave and their appointment is protected, sir. A directive from the government would be very, very helpful. Equally disturbing, sir, yesterday there was a news in Warangal. Many junior doctors were driven out of their homes by landlords, and they've used the word saying that these doctors are infected, these doctors are dirty, and they are literally on the roads. And I think a community must be very sensitive to the medical profession at a time like this, and we request you to issue a directive in this regard. The fourth point, sir, is that this is a long drawn battle. We need to strategize, we need to strategize the workforce, we need to have a backup workforce, we need to replenish our workforce. So just like the Kerala yesterday has recruited 300 people who are on the wait list of the Public Service Commission, we need to ensure that we have a backup of staff that are available who can be used in this crisis. And final point, sir, is despite your message to the nation and despite several state chapters issuing guidance documents to private hospitals, still elective surgeries are happening in big hospitals. And the point is about these elective surgeries, when elective surgeries happen, the ICU beds are utilized, and if very few ICU beds are available, if a crisis occurs, we will be in difficulty. So a stronger message must go out. And finally, sir, an appeal to you as the Honorable Prime Minister of our country. You have brought unprecedented unity amongst the entire nation. In your televised address to the nation, you have successfully invoked the sankalp and the sanyam, the resolve and the resilience amongst the people. And within 72 hours, you have been able to implement the world's largest social experiment, where everyone listened to you and stayed at home for a self-imposed lockdown, and you brought in that much needed awareness about, you know, social distancing. Sir, your word is taken very seriously, and my humble appeal to you is that if you are able to, in this time of crisis, appear more often through your televised address to the nation, it will give that much needed boost, moral boost to our nation. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, doctor. I now request Dr. Alpesh Gandhi.